boys, I call them op. The phone's out and I'm jocking. I can think of many episodes.
Showtime! Hey, it's Larry here, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. Welcome to the show. We're doing a video podcast today. I'm here with Jeffrey. Hi, Jeff.
Why, hello. Nice. You're all the way over there. We have so much room.
And we have over there, way over to your left, is James Monosmith. He's going to be talking about Xbox gear. Hi, James.
Hey, guys. How you doing? Hey.
We're doing great, man. Into the microphone. You want to
Into the microphone.
You got some stuff to show off. I've been talking about this. I talked about it yesterday. We're going to world premiere. This is a day. I mean, I'm going to feel like Jeff Keighley. This is a day of world premieres. Here's why. This is the very first time we're doing the show from this brand new studio. It's the very first time
so spacious.
Seeing this set.
Use
James has got some stuff that no one else has seen before.
No one.
Nope.
So.
Not even you.
well,
we designed them in the dark.
Yeah, exactly.
Now we're just going to go
I don't know what we're going to show. This is going to be exciting.
If you're watching us on Facebook, you want to head over to mixer.com/Major Nelson. We have got some stuff to give away in the chat. Make sure the chat. Come on, don't be internet chat. Be cool chat. So hang out.
We have the chat here going.
So you do. Okay. I don't have it.
I've got it. So okay. I'm keeping an eye on it. If you have anything interesting to say, we'll repeat it here. Interesting.
Just going through. We got some stuff we're gonna show. I don't know where this came from, but this was in my shirt, Jeff. Do you know anything about that?
Bring you back some horrible flashbacks of about 10,000 of these.
We did Inside Xbox earlier this week. It was a great show. We announced Rocket League is coming to Game Pass. It came to Game Pass.
Yes, that's right. It's there now.
Yeah.
It's people are playing it. It's a lot of fun. And you have to get those Major Nelson flags.
Woo, it's free.
A lot like that.
It's
although
free.
Without this
beautiful rotate.
Spinning logo.
It does.
That's 60 FPS, Larry?
That's real
4K HDR. We've got it all
right there.
Your logo is enhanced for Xbox One X.
It is a lot of fun here. So we're really excited to do the show today. It's a new place for us, a new location. We're back from E3. What an E3 we had, Jeff. I mean, we talked about it on the last podcast with Graham. And a lot of the excitement was, you know, we had a new venue. James, your team was there.
Yeah.
I want to talk. We're going to talk. Okay. Show the stuff later on, but I want to right at the top of the show. I want to talk about the gear store and what you guys are doing because it's really exciting.
Yeah, for sure. You know, this is something that I think we've all been wanting to happen here at Xbox for like forever. So we finally figured out a way to make it work within what we're doing, and I think a big part of that actually was being able to create the Xbox experience at the Microsoft Theater, and that gave us an opening to look at how we bring merchandise to our fans.
Right.
Basically, the higher-ups gave me a permission to go ahead and see if you can figure out a way to bring a store and bring new merchandise to the fans. And so
right.
we went after it. So what we're doing is we went ahead and created what we call Xbox Official Gear, which is an initiative across multiple fronts. The big part of it, one, we're finally making Xbox-branded merchandise for the very, very first time. The first time we're creating it, all new looks, all new products.
Right.
Everything that we're bringing out to retail, and the second, and what we did at E3 is we launched event-based stores,
right?
Pop-ups, as we call them,
with event-focused gear.
Yeah, event-focused gear, and also like you know, I know, and I've been to countless conventions and different shows that it's really fun to buy stuff when you're at them. It's like it's a transactional adventure for yourself. And we wanted to take advantage of the fact that our fans are in one place and create a larger experience. Like, you know, Xbox is more than just gaming.
Sure.
It's a lifestyle for us. So
it's a whole community.
It's a community,
it's
right.
It's a whole community.
Totally.
And we saw that with FanFest. We saw that with everything we do is about our fans. And we saw that with you know, bringing the fans in there. And this is just part of that story and the hub of excitement.
Yeah, I mean, it's just it's an extension of what we do. I mean, we've been doing it a lot with our IPs for a long time. Obviously, Halo and Minecraft and Gears have great products that are out there, especially when we launch new titles, and they have great stores. But we're like, well, why don't we bring it all together under our banner of Xbox and bring it to our fans and bring people together with it. So we were able to launch at E3 with our official store, and it's our first pop-up and the first of many to come. You know, our goal is to have these pop-up shops at every one of our major events, not only in the U.S. but globally. So, you know, we're kind of in the crawl, walk, run phase of it, but we're definitely ramping up to be it more.
I'd love to talk about the designs. Like,
sure.
About a month or two before E3, you had shown us a catalog of what's in there, and I was looking at it, and it's not what I expected, everything being green and, like, just logo on shirt, which is kind of like standard merch fare.
Yeah.
But more... like artistic takes on the brand. And how was that received?
Yeah, I mean, the way that we kind of approached it is we didn't want to create what the word that I hate more than anything, which is swag. I don't want to create swag. We're tired of swag. I don't want Microsoft.
And just to be clear, swag in the games industry, or frankly in any industry, because I've been working in the broadcast industry for a long time, is that cheap stuff.
Cheap stuff you just give away, right?
And
you throw it out.
In 6 months, you're like, I don't need this anymore.
It's like 80% of my entire wardrobe.
And I can confirm, I've been to Jeff's house. It's nothing but gaming t-shirts.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We wanted to create apparel that people are proud to wear. They want to wear out, generally speaking, that they can wear to the office, they can wear out, and not just be something that they wear at a convention and never wear again. And with Xbox, and the way that we looked at it is we wanted to embrace, gamers and gaming culture. And gaming culture isn't just about the IP or actually playing the game. There's a lifestyle around it. And so we worked and teamed up with a company called MetaThreads on our initial Xbox designs.
Sure.
And MetaThreads is kind of known for combining esports, gaming culture, and streetwear into like kind of one mesh, which, to be honest, a lot of gamers kind of relate to.
Huge crossover.
Yeah. Even like amongst sneakerheads, in hip hop and streetwear. And we kind of took a look at that and looked at what is fashionable, what is stuff that we would like to wear out. And that's kind of where we came out. I know we see it all like inside of the catalogs and on the web store, but I brought some of the samples so we can actually see what it looks like.
We have a visual podcast.
Yeah, we have a visual podcast. We're sitting right here. I'm wearing our hoodie, which is our linear hoodie, which I personally love. It's just a different kind of cut and different look to it. But what else do I got here? I've got our this is kind of standard fare. We have our flat bill snapback. You can't have a collection without a flat bill snapback.
Well, Larry loves the flat bill.
Yes.
Every weekend, I'm like, I'm not brushing my hair. I debatably did not brush my hair today. I'm wearing a hat, and he just is like, can I just grab that and bend it? And you actually did that.
I'm curious what the chat thinks. Is the hat flat, or do you want to have a little bit of English to it?
Well, I don't. Why can't you do all have everything in between? I think just different looks for different styles.
Right.
Like you know,
no,
like
when I see the flat hat,
Well, look, there's a dad hat.
There's a dad hat.
It's time for a dad hat.
Right? Here we go.
I mean, it's what it is. It's a dad hat.
When you have athletic hats. When I go camping or I play softball or baseball, I have a curved bill. But you know, when I just want to throw something on to go out, you go with the flat bill.
I think it. Looking at the chat, it's pretty close to 50-50. Yeah. Bend is for fishermen. I agree.
Bend is for fishermen.
Yeah, yeah. It's like. You're like trying to keep the lures from hitting you in the eye or something.
Wow. All right.
You know?
I mean, it's also helpful to keep the sun out of your eyes.
I guess.
Now let's be clear. There's only one hat skew. You're responsible for bending it yourself.
Well, no, we do have a dad hat.
Okay.
Thank
here
you.
We go.
So if you want a pre-curved,
yes,
there is the white dad hat, which we have available right now.
Okay. Like dad shoes are coming back. Kanye, basically, you know, when Kanye was
Kanye
younger,
bit it from Pete Carroll.
Started from what? Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's like. Like he gained weight. He's older now. He's in his 40s now. He's now sweatpants.
All right, next. Yeah. Let's keep going with the gear.
Okay, let's see what else we got here.
Larry's not interested in that.
This here is just a simple crew shirt, white, which is I love it. I know you got to be careful when you wear this out to dinner. Or else it's going to get ruined very, very quickly.
Who wants pasta?
Yeah, exactly. Like, don't go.
I haven't seen that. Can you?
Look
really
at
nice.
This one's awesome.
Really nice.
What is that? What is that tag on the back? That's like a billboard.
Well, okay, that's really right. That's a huge tag.
It's huge.
Here, pass it on. This
thing, like a 7-Eleven receipt.
It is so fluffy and soft. It feels like wearing a marshmallow.
This is great.
You're not getting that back.
So. Yeah, I know. That's gone now.
So this is part of the Metagear, right?
Yeah, that's part of the Metagear collection. Yeah. Let's see. This one I love too. So I know it's July, but I'm bringing away all of our sweaters because I just think they're awesome.
It's July in Seattle. It's not exactly hot.
That's true. But this one is awesome. This is like the camo pullover windbreaker. So this thing is very much on trend with the front pocket, but it just looks awesome. A really cool cut. Zippers on the side. I love this thing. It's just a kind of a cool fashion statement. And from Xbox, we actually pulled design from one of our most popular controllers.
There's the one of the Forces controllers.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And so we pulled that camo design from it to kind of bring it into this collection, which I love. And then final thing I brought this to kind of show off from this collection is our best-selling item and the thing
Darn
I
it.
Love.
Darn it!
Which, okay, second best-selling item.
Okay.
Larry, if you don't know, is referring to the Major Nelson-approved pin.
Now I have to say that this is
sold out.
Jeff and I have worked together for a long time. James, you and I have worked together. Is that whenever I would go out and do events, I don't have one on right now because we're casual today. But people would ask me, where do I get the pin? And then you guys came to me months ago and said, hey, could we sell the pin? And we struck a deal.
Yes.
I said, you can sell this type of pin. And you kind of touched up the design, a beautiful card on it. And I remember when we announced everything at E3, I told James, James, I want to sell out of them. And with your help, we did.
Yeah, we did. It may make a comeback again, though, too, for the fans that missed out.
Stay tuned.
The fans
in
West Edmonton would like you to have a pop-up in the mall there. I hear that's
okay.
a huge
I've
mall.
Been to that mall.
Isn't that the mall where BioWare is like connected to that mall?
Yeah, I opened that store. Yeah. Anyway, so this is one of the top selling items.
This is one of our top selling items, and I love it. I know Jeff loves it too, which is our Xbox Bomber jacket.
Yeah.
I mean, this thing is just kind of a really cool take on some fashion items. We have one of the cool things that I love about this is Meta always includes these Velcro patch sections on the side of the jacket, and we actually released some Xbox patches. But we're going to be doing other patches as well. The idea is you can form your own identity. So you'll see stuff coming out from our IPs. You'll see Gears of War. You'll see Halo patches that you can then put on this jacket. So this is a piece that you'll have for a long time.
We need a Major Nelson radio patch, right, Jeff?
Right?
I love that. I just want to take a
yeah,
look at that.
Touch it. It's great.
Members only.
Now it's going away. Members only.
Anyway, we got some stuff we're going to show up later on, but we want to thank everybody. Jeff, I want to talk about some of the headlines and some of the news, and then we're going to show later on.
We can do that.
On,
we can talk about what we're playing.
What we're playing, actually, before we go, before we leave the store, if we can bring up the console right here, this is actually really important. James, you guys worked with the console team. Is that you showed off some of this stuff. You can actually buy it right on your Xbox One.
That's right, yeah.
So if you go over to the store tab and then you scroll down all the way to the bottom, right here, there it is.
Xbox
and this will actually
gear.
Go into the store, and you can browse on it and see all of the stuff that James was just talking about.
Yeah.
And you can buy it on your console.
Yeah.
That is, look at that. The T's out of stock. The Destination T is out of stock.
The Destination T is out of stock. But we have all, just so people who have been looking and keeping an eye out, we have a bunch of stuff out of stock. But we'll see a new surge of product coming in online by the end of the month. It is hitting the DCs next week.
And so one of the differences between swag, and I'm wearing, look, I'm a big Overwatch fan, and Overwatch playoffs are going on. I'm wearing
a
it's like it's a Gildan shirt, which are not necessarily, you know, Egyptian cotton or anything like that. I'm having abrasions as we speak, but worth it. But the Meta Threads is really nice quality shirts.
Yeah, it's super high in quality. We have sewn on labels, but you know the idea behind gear is it's just a higher quality product and something that you want to pay money for.
I feel like I should be saying. And today's extra value.
Yeah, exactly.
But we're not
doing
selling them here. Go to your console. You don't need me to sell you anything.
Well, and I also want to say, like, other than the Xbox gear, we also have the stuff from our other brands. As you can see, like, you know, we have stuff from Mixer, from PUBG, from Halo, all kinds of really cool items across all of our main IPs, and even some third-party stuff. I believe we have some items from Division 2 and Tomb Raider and some more things coming.
Now, I went to the Halo gear because I want to just point out for a moment that James has been working on Halo merchandise for years.
Yes, yeah.
So this is whence you come from.
It is whence I come from.
So, you know, when we to your point a little bit earlier on, when we were talking about, hey, we want to do Xbox merchandise, we looked around and realized we already have experts.
Yeah.
And that's you.
Yeah, my team, we've been working on the Halo merchandise for 6-7 years now, multiple launches, and it's something that's a big passion for us. But, you know, while we're looking at the Funko Pops, I actually did bring in for you guys, you can do it as you will.
Oh, look at this.
Two exclusive Halo Funko Pops.
Look at this.
So I have the Best Buy only Gold Arbiter,
right,
which is awesome, and then the GameStop only Chief with Energy Sword.
Nice.
Oh, that's awesome.
So these are exclusive items just released.
Thank you.
You guys can keep them. You can give them
I think we have to give them away.
Yeah, I think
we're not allowed to keep them on the show.
We'll
but these
that.
Look
yeah.
really nice.
We'll yeah, they're player. Super cool.
Look at those. Those are awesome.
Close up.
But yeah, you guys have a lot. The Halo has a long history of doing amazing merchandise. I mean, God, I remember having a bag from like Halo 2.
Yeah,
back in the day.
Halo 2 was the first title where we actually launched major merchandise. For
right.
Halo 1, we didn't do anything. It was, I think the only thing we released was the console. Was
can
the
we,
custom
can we
console?
Talk about the premium or the object that we never released? Do you know which one it is?
Which one, the shoe?
No, this was back in the day. At least I don't think it was ever released. We had keychains. And they were shotgun shell keychains.
Oh,
remember that?
Yeah.
And they in a case.
Well, we also
I got one though. I got one.
A pair of Gilbert Arenas Halo 3 Adidas shoes.
Oh my God!
So there was a collab there, but then Gilbert Arenas, the great Hibachi, got into some trouble in the NBA.
Right.
And the shoes ended up.
Good old number zero.
Yeah, got pulled. But we still have a pair of them on display in our museum at 343.
Right.
That museum, by the way, is amazing. I think there's some videos out there. I think Jeff Easterling pretty recently did.
Yeah,
like
did a new one.
Yeah, those are worth watching. Well, you know what? I'm going to link out to that.
All right, James, you're going to stay with us because we're going to show some stuff later on. We're going to talk about what we're playing. We're going to talk about some news. We got a whole, what time is it? Oh, it's 11. It's 15 minutes. 15 minutes. Let's jump into what we're playing. Right now, Jeff, this is actually, if we can bring up my console, this is actually my console here. We can actually bring up look at all these achievements. We'll bring up the achievements. Vermintide. I want to talk about Vermintide because I know that you're playing Vermintide.
Yeah, yeah. I started playing this last night. So Warhammer 2 Vermintide. This is part of the of Xbox Game Pass for that just, I guess, 2 days ago or yesterday it went into Game Pass, which is great. So this is a really elaborate first-person cooperative dungeon crawler.
Booting it up right now.
It almost feels like if they had made the old Gauntlet games into a first-person type of game with the different classes. You have your brawler, you have your sort of elf rogue, you have a magic user, you have a dwarf with a crossbow. There's one other class as well. But there's a lot of character and personality. And what you do after you go through the prologue, which I highly recommend, you start with the prologue. It sort of establishes these vermin that you have to turn the tide on, I guess. Sort of like rat soldiers. And lets you get a hold of like what the gameplay is like. And then you go into quick play. You have sort of a hub town. And from there, you sort of jump in and you match up with other folks. You can play offline, but I think this is a game you're not going to want to solo. You're going to want to just go into that matchmaking or set up a private match where you're playing with friends. And since it's on Game Pass, it should be no problem to get everybody together and to get this game. So it's a game we need to play.
Yes.
I'm looking forward to getting some more folks in there. I'm already calling. I'm going to use the Elf Rogue character. I feel like Hanzo running around there. And but there's some really good voice acting in there as well. So if you, the Warhammer universe is pretty rich. I've played a couple of games of very varying sort of types. There was a top-down strategy RPG I played on iPad a few years ago. I don't know everything that's happening. And you know what? That's fine. You're going to go through. You're going to bash some rats in the head with a massive hammer.
Right.
And that's what you care about, right?
Yeah, that's all you really care about.
I mean, bashing.
Yeah.
Bashing.
It's important. They're vectors for disease.
Yeah. We're talking here about what we're playing. What else are you playing? You want to talk about this guy right down here?
What are we looking at?
Bomber Crew.
Bomber Crew. Yes.
That was a game that we announced it earlier in the week, right?
Yeah. This is another game that came straight out of that debuted into Xbox Game Pass. We're seeing a lot more of that, which is really cool. So it's not just games that you may have played in the past or missed in the past, and this is access to that, but actually, this is a brand new game, and you get to play it on day one through Xbox Game Pass, which I really love. So Bomber Crew, if you ever played FTL, it's very similar to that. And what that is sort of like it's a game where you're controlling a plane. FTL was a game where you're controlling a ship in space, and you're sort of managing the activities of all these different crew on this bomber in a very cartoony World War II, and you're running sorties out of an airbase a little bit north of London. And so you're flying over to Belgium and you're taking out
a
bomb
plane?
Factory.
Did
do
I,
it.
I sent you my plane, didn't I?
I think you did. Yeah, just RB one
here
more
it is.
Time.
Here it is. So this is
this is the best part. You can totally reskin it, and you can put the logo as your gamer pick.
It's the Deathmobile. Yes. And it automatically picks up your gamer picture on it.
I think I made mine Virgin America. But you can as you play through, you get to customize it more and more. But if you go through and if you want to launch one of the missions, you're telling your different characters what to do.
Right.
So you're not actually just like in control directly of the throttle of the plane. It's not a normal like flight sim type of game. Rather, this is like a game that challenges you to like how well can you manage stress in like a crazy situation. So like give you an example, like once you get a hold of it, and I was flying, I was like, I'm doing really good at this game, and then I did like a tougher mission, and at all at once I'm trying to take out a bombing target, I'm escorting a ship, I'm keeping subs off of it. We're getting strafed by flak guns, and my radio person was hit.
Yeah.
And one of my engines was on fire, and my electrical system went down. All of this was at once.
Chaos.
So how do I prioritize that? Well, I still have to hit this bombing run. I can't take a second run at it because I'm not going to be able to survive. But I got to fix my electrical system. I have to send someone out on the wing to put this fire out. I only have one first aid kit. So you're just like, all of these things are happening. I think I was saying on Inside Xbox, like, this should be part of getting like a management degree. Like, if you want to get your MBA, you should have to be able to successfully do this. Because at the end, it's like, all right, we finished the mission. Four of my crew did not make it back, which is unfortunate. And but hey, we finished the mission, and that's what really mattered. And so it gets more and more complicated,
check
but
it
it's really fun, and it's on Xbox Game Pass. So get in there.
Yeah, what are you what are you waiting for?
What are you waiting for? You have no reason not to play.
Yeah, it's one of those games that I was like, because you and I were texting back and forth, and I just sent you the photo of my death.
Yeah, yeah. I was like, see, you're playing and doing it. And I'm like, looking on my friends list, like a lot of people are giving this a shot. So I had never played a game by Curve Digital or by this team before, but I really like what they did with this, and it's really fun. So it's on Game Pass. Give it a shot.
Looking at my achievements right now to see what I'm playing. I'm playing a little bit of, who is that? Look, I'm apparently, you're right behind me in GamerScore.
Yeah, it does rain a little bit.
That's ahead of me. 475. Who's that guy?
He's one of the mods, so be very nice, Richard.
But we got Bomber
Are
Crew.
You playing Overwatch as well?
Played Overwatch last night a little bit. Weekend. Just Cause is a game I keep going back to. James, have you played that?
Yeah, Just Cause is awesome.
It's just crazy fun to run around. Halo MCC Insider, which is a lot of insiders are playing that. We'll talk about that later. Player on a public test server went online last night. They're tweaking some weapon balance and doing some other stuff as well. So Overlord, I love those. The Overlord series came to back compat. This is not a back compat game. Came to that vigor. This one, 911 Operator. Did I tell you about this one, Jeff?
How did I miss this game?
I was playing it over the weekend, and James, have you seen this game?
I haven't.
So this game is you can go download it now. What's interesting is it's exactly what you think it is. It's a top-down view of a map.
You don't know where my head is, because I'm like, does this have William Shatner from Rescue 911?
No, but what it's interesting is it detects where you are and says, oh, I see you're in Seattle. Do you want to download the Seattle map? So it downloads the Seattle map from Bing Maps, Google Maps, whoever maps, and it starts during the game. It's calling out different ambulance and heart attack and baby being born and whatnot around town at real addresses.
All right, well, now I'm actually going to have to do this.
So I was like, well, that's kind of cool. And then I was like, wait a minute. And I switched out to my little town that I grew up in Connecticut with 10,000 people. And sure enough, it had it. And sure enough, it starts calling out like a car fire down here on Flanders Road. I'm like, yeah, that would happen.
Paula had her baby.
Yeah, exactly.
I didn't think I'd find out this way.
Exactly. So it's just a fun game to kind of play around. So check that out. Hey, we're watching the chat right now. If you're over on Facebook, go to mixer.com/MajorNelson. Couple of questions in the chat. Want to answer them right now. Number one question that I'm seeing, James.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. The international audience wants to know.
They do. I'm sure.
What up? When can they buy their stuff internationally? Right now, it's U.S. only.
U.S. only, the store. So we do have a 5 to 6 month roadmap right now. We're going to be igniting these up soon. Canada's the next up.
Yep.
I'm hoping to have that up and going within a month.
Okay.
Then we should be going live in Canada. After that, we're going to be targeting UK, Germany, and the greater EMEA European area.
Yep.
It's going to make a lot of people happy.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
That'll happen. We're working on it to happen this year by holiday time so people can get it. That being said,
yes,
XOG Shop will be at Gamescom. So if you're going to Gamescom, this is an exclusive.
I'm going to Gamescom.
Debuted to let you know now, we will be at Gamescom in the merch hall selling our official lines there. So that'll be the
You've
first
been to Gamescom,
case.
Right?
I have it. This will be my first time
ever.
Oh,
Jeff and I are going?
We're
going
to take you under our wing.
We're
going
to go some Kolsching.
Oh, we will definitely be Kolsching.
Oh.
Kolsch is the sort of local brew that is only in Cologne, they love it. Yeah. Anywhere else, they hate it. But you know what? I'm a big fan. It's a great summer drink.
You know what they don't have? You know what they don't? Jeff and I have learned this after going for
salad.
Air. They don't have air conditioning.
Ah.
Or they don't have American air conditioning. So I'll just say that.
They give you a fan with a spritzer bottle.
Pretty much.
They have it, but it just doesn't go any lower than about 80 degrees.
It's lovely. So.
Yeah. The days of it being like this, where it's like 65.
Have you ever heard of Curryverse?
Curryverse? Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. More like Curry Best. Am I right?
We're gonna.
Huh?
Am I right?
Hey-o.
Night, everybody.
Thank you very much.
No, anyway. And the gummy bears.
Yeah, we got a lot to talk about. But
okay.
Yeah, so that's good to know is that you are. So it's not that the team doesn't want to roll out the gear store, but there's a lot you got to make sure you got fulfillment in the region. You're got all the right licenses to sell. I mean, there's all sorts of stuff.
A lot of it is compliance. What we can get away with in the U.S. is not necessarily okay with everywhere around.
All of a sudden,
world,
like XL. What does that mean to you folks in EMEA? It doesn't mean anything.
Right.
Have you gone to Zara? Because sizes are a little different there. I'm like a 3X European size. Here, I'm just I'm a roomy medium.
So, yeah, there you go.
Make you feel good here in America.
Feel good. So there's a lot, but I know you guys want to bring it out to as many.
We do. I mean, we want
all the Xbox regions.
Everywhere we're at, we want to be. Yeah.
People want watches. People want kid sizes. People want big boy sizes. I'm just.
Yeah, I am working on some stuff with you guys.
We are. So big boy sizes. So people know we are working to make sure our lines are up to 4X and big girl sizes. We want to make sure that we have female cuts for most of our product lines. So we are working on that as well. Okay. I think we are already up to almost 40 to 50% of our lines have female cuts as well, at least with the Xbox line. So we are taking care of that.
Okay.
Trying to get up to 4X. So these are, you know, we're definitely aware of the issues we need to solve for.
Yeah.
We definitely sprinted with our hair on fire to get out in time for
E3. Yes, you did.
Yeah. And I'm just now putting it out. So now the next step is how do we make this a better service for our fans?
I feel like the sky's the limit here.
It totally. We're just started.
There's nowhere to go.
So much more to go.
Yeah, there's nowhere to go. There's a lot of stuff there. All right, we're getting back to what we're playing. Thank you for joining us there. So that's that was kind of crazy, wasn't it?
Are you playing the World Cup watching game, Larry?
All the time.
I think you're playing it whether you want to or not, because we've had it on in the office all month long.
Who do you
have now? Croatia, France. Really? Yeah. All right.
I'm just trying to see what I'm unlocking.
I mean, I guess you like an underdog.
Second smallest country to be in the World Cup finals.
Second only to Iceland, yes. Yeah, that's a good call.
I'm seeing if I have anything else here. I think that's pretty
Larry doesn't like talking about
I'm
sports.
I'm listening to you.
Like
you see Flame in the Flood up here. The reason you see Flame in the Flood up here is A, because it's a good game.
And B, look at that gamer score.
It supports Fast Start. Which is a brand new feature that we shipped last week with the most recent update. There's some other cool features in there, including, I don't have it on here, but we also have groups. So you can create your groups here and decide what games you want. I'll show you my group. For some reason, my groups aren't on here. But Flame of the Flood, and this is just in. Breaking news, as the internet likes to say. We have two more titles. A bunch are already in there, but we added Fast Start support today for Neverwinter and Fable Fortune.
Well, that's good.
So this is a brand new technology that's going to allow you to play your games faster.
And that's what people want.
That's what people want. They want their games faster. More games, faster games, better games, and extra large.
Yeah, with the groups like you were talking about, I know we couldn't demo it right there, but you can... Previously, you had pins, and pins kind of became like a one-size-fits-all, and people would use it in different ways. I actually would use it in games to remind myself, hey, this is sort of my like stack of shame, if you will. Like, I got to go back and play this game and finish this game.
Right.
But now I can actually make a stack of shame pile.
You know what I can have on mine is I don't have it here, but I have a folder that says crossplay. Right.
Oh.
Like you, and
we can do that.
Yeah. Yeah. So. And you can very soon add Rocket League to that list.
That's right.
That Rocket ID will be pretty cool. We'll get more on that once we have the details.
All right, we should probably go through. Do you want to talk about?
Yes, we can talk.
James,
about
we didn't actually. We like to ask our guests what they're playing, and you're our guest. So
let's see. What am I playing right now? I am currently playing Destiny 2 again.
Yep.
I'm jumping back in.
Yeah.
With the expansion happening in September, I felt like I needed to kind of get through and get my characters leveled up.
Did you play when it first came out?
Yeah, I'm a huge Destiny fan. Destiny 2, I loved. I played a lot. And then, like everything else, a bajillion games came out, and I kind of put it to the side. And I only played the first. I bought the whole thing. I only played the first DLC. I didn't even play the second one.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, you know what? I need to get back in. And like like any game like that, like that's big, as soon as you go back in, you're like, I do not remember at all what I'm supposed to do, and this is almost overwhelming. But after a little bit, getting the mechanics back into place, I was like, oh, yeah, that's right. There's a grind loop that I thoroughly enjoy in the Destiny franchise. I'm excited about the expansion. So I'm in there. I'm trying to level up my character to get ready for it to go.
Yeah.
Yeah, I actually think
Larry's in my clan that I started.
I am in your clan.
Yeah, yeah, which is awesome. You haven't been in a while, but we keep you there.
Yes,
in case you want to jump back in.
I do.
Rewards.
I need to go in there when we're not traveling and doing all sorts of other fun stuff. Anyway, so we're talking about some news. Want to go through some headlines, Jeffrey?
Yeah. Why don't we do
headlines?
That? Why don't we keep
you know,
it?
We need to go full screen here. We need a lighting change for the news. You know, the news comes in different colors.
It does.
So let's do a rainbow of colors here, and let's see if that'll work.
I
think it worked. No, it's up. There it is.
Look at that.
So it's amazing.
I like that.
When the news happens, you can just put it on.
I can put on the jacket. And then we
a lot of money
have, like,
went into that. A lot of money went into that queue. So, all right. Let's go through.
It wasn't at all underwhelming either.
Yeah.
All right. So we've already talked about Rocket League, but yes, now available on Xbox Game Pass. A game that I'm really looking forward to, that's less than a month out now, that has had a lot of buzz, Dead Cells. So this is a game that's like a Roguevania So you of course know the Metroidvania sort of genre, and this is sort of adds a roguelite sort of element to that. A lot of people have been talking about Dead Cells, looking forward to it. It's coming out August 7th on Xbox One. And so we have a story up there on Xbox Wire, which I can link out to, and it sort of talks about how this game had evolved over time. We're taking a look at it now. Had evolved. It originally was planned to be like a tower defense game, and they ended up finding, by sort of testing out in the fly, like what people are into and the things that stuck with it. So this game, we're seeing a lot of like really good 2D, where it's not, I think the days of like, hey, it's retro for retro's sake has gone away, and I think that's just now, hey, we can use these mechanics and add modern gameplay twists to sort of classic looks and make a really good game. So anyway, that's coming out less than a month from now. Talk about Minecraft. Minecraft never stops.
Yeah.
It's only just like a couple weeks ago that we first were able to unlock achievements on our Nintendo Switch.
Did you do that?
Of course I did.
I did too. It's got this weird like at sign. I mean, it's
cool. They got the sound right.
You know what? The fact that I worked on that sound back in the day and that it's now on Nintendo, it just warms my heart.
It did. You worked on the rare achievement.
I worked on the original achievement. I worked on especially the rare achievement with the flourish.
Yeah.
So like that was a lot of fun. Yeah.
So on Minecraft, the update Aquatic Phase 2 is out. And
more fish.
There's a lot. Well, there's really a lot of stuff in here. Because it used to be you'd go underwater. There wasn't a ton to do. But now there's like sea turtles, which that alone
is.
Those are,
they can be mean. I'm a scuba diver. You avoid sea turtles. You can't touch them because they're protected species. But when they come after you, they can hurt.
This is one of the many reasons that the only way I'd go in the water is probably in Minecraft.
All right.
Yeah, not doing it. Anyway, there's new mobs. There's really a lot. They've added skeleton horses. There's a lot of stuff. Dolphins.
Very Westworld of them with their skeleton horses.
Right.
Yeah. Thestrals, I think they're called in Harry Potter.
Yeah.
That was a really show of my nerd side there. Yeah. Not everyone can see them. You have to experience death.
You have to see death, yeah.
I've seen things. Seen things.
Back
so anyway,
news.
A lot of stuff there. we'll link off to Minecraft.net, but really a ton of new stuff there. And I mean, the game just keeps on going, and you can play it. Oh, and it's coming, of course, to Xbox One. It's coming to Switch. Coming to Windows 10. Coming to VR and your mobile devices.
Yeah,
everywhere.
Wherever you are, Minecraft will be there.
All right. So James, you were talking about getting back into Destiny. Very recently, we got back into playing The Division after Division 2 got announced, and there was a lot of stuff waiting for us. Well, Battlefield 5.
There was a crazy amount of stuff waiting for us.
Yeah. So Battlefield 5, people are excited about that, and they're doing something similar with Battlefield 1. So if you go back into Battlefield 1, they're throwing a ton of content at you. There's a lot of like challenges, which is also seems like sort of reminiscent of how The Division is doing some stuff with Division 1 that goes into 2. So there's a great story up on Xbox Wire, which we can link into, that just sort of lets you know, like if you're jonesing for Battlefield 5, and it looks really good, that if you go back into Battlefield 1 right now, there are things, and even in Battlefield 4, actually, that are waiting for you that are free that maybe weren't accessible.
Look, at the end of the day, I need to fly my helicopters. You know that.
Yeah.
I'm a helicopter.
And I like to repair them.
I mean, yeah, we are a great team.
We're a couple of support guys.
Exactly.
We help. We'll leave the headshots.
There's actually a funny thread on Reddit that popped up last week, and there was talking about how somebody played us in Overwatch, and they said they used to play. This person came up against, I think it was you and I in Battlefield, and how they were surprised because we were ferrying people to and from the point.
Yeah,
we were playing the objective.
Exactly.
Right? And that's what the game's all about. It's not about the KD in Battlefield.
Well, look, sometimes the adults need to come into the room and actually manage our way through.
Right. That was a lot of fun.
Well, that's good. So that is pretty much it. Oh, one last thing. We have something visual.
Yes.
This was something beautiful. You may or may not have seen our episode of Inside Xbox this week, but you revealed it.
Yes.
I can reveal
it again. You ready? Can we go to the two shot? Here we go. You ready? You ready? Dun, dun, dun. Dun, dun, dun. There it is.
Wow.
This is beautiful. This is beautiful.
Gorgeous.
Yeah.
Look at this thing. This is the
Hey, you need white gloves.
Oh my God.
I don't have them. Never mind.
You don't have them.
I don't have them either.
We'll leave it there. That is the Sport white controller.
Yep.
It is
Hold it up.
All right, well, now I'm afraid. I can't touch things without
you need the white gloves.
White gloves. So it's got the design, but I think, which looks really nice. Obviously, I'm looking for the camera to see if we're on it. But I really love the back specifically. I mean, that is a beautiful color. It has the gray offsite rubberized grips, which are particularly nice. But it's just like, it's a very nice looking controller. And you were talking about like an overlap in like sneaker culture and gaming culture and street culture. And we see this with controls as well. Like always on Instagram, we're seeing people that are showing off their collection of controllers. And I think this is one that will be particularly...
That's beautiful.
Nice. Have you gotten a hold of this one yet?
It looks like the 270s that you have.
It does look... Yeah, I have the pink 270s, but the 270s, the teal one, yes.
Those are sneaker tops.
I'm just trying to fill people in. It's probably mine. Yeah.
Wow.
Right?
This is gorgeous.
Yeah.
What's interesting is I look at that color, and I love that color. But it's one of those ones where you look at it, is it going to be like, you know, avocado was in the 70s, where it was all hip, and then all of a sudden we're looking at it and I'm going, ooh, no.
Well, this is why you have the rainbow colored, the chroma.
Cover everything.
Set.
Roy G. Biv,
no matter what it is, yeah.
Roy G. Biv.
We're hitting 4,028 colors, whatever number it is. I don't know what VGA is. We're VGA here. 4096. I was close. I was within tolerances.
We have more?
Just want to really quickly go through. This was a pretty busy week for releases, especially on the Xbox side. So we talked about Bomber Crew, Defiance 2050, Hotel Transylvania 3. This is obviously a tie-in with the Adam Sandler movie. MXGP Pro, a sort of a BMX or motocross sort of game. You kids like the JRPGs. Shining Resonance Refrain. Which sounds like, I think it's from Sega, one of the Shining series. 2OXX, so that is a reference that will be familiar to anyone who played like the old Mega Man games. It always took place in the year 20XX, and this is a sort of a Mega Man-inspired sort of game. 20XX.
I don't see that on here. I'm looking right now. I'm looking at the, if you pull up, you can just go to the store, and it's got all the new releases right
here. There were so many that you may have missed it.
There it is.
There we go. Ghost 1.0, Super Destronaut DX, which is like sort of like an old school Space Invaders retro shooter. We talked about Warhammer Vermintide 2. A game that I'm really looking forward to on Friday. We have a couple more games coming out later this week. Actually, four games coming out this week. But the one that I'm most excited for is Earthfall. Have you seen this?
Yeah, that looks awesome.
It's actually made like right down the street.
I did the interview with the guys on Inside.
You did. They were on Inside Xbox.
The zombie game tour. I'm sorry, the alien game.
Yes.
The alien game, but it is very much reminiscent, I would say, if you were a fan of Left 4 Dead, four-player co-op game where you're tackling hordes.
We never played that, did we?
No, I was working at Sony at the time.
Yeah, it was me and Laura and Jeff and Steptoe, and there's a famous story about the gnome. So
I don't know that story. Well, anyway, why don't we make our own stories?
We will make our own.
Starting this week, we'll support local business.
Yep.
Because that team is just like literally right down the street. I think I saw some references in the game to the Pacific
Northwest.
They're
actually down the street?
They're actually, depends on which street. But
they're actually down the street.
They're actually down the street. And then there's three more games, Insane Robots, The Spectrum Retreat, and Kentaro's Revenge. So that's a pretty big week. People talk about the summer being sort of dead.
Yeah.
But there's a lot to play.
Can you hold that controller up one more time?
Yeah.
I want to just remind people, tomorrow, I will be giving a couple of these away on my Twitter account. Yep, just got a free code Friday. We're going to do free controller Friday. We got some games to give away.
That works.
But we're going to have this lovely controller right here. You're going to get your very own version of it. So just follow me on Major Nelson, at Major Nelson on Twitter. You can't miss it.
Yeah.
So
it's all for the followers.
It is. Well, no, it's all for the people.
I meant the people that are following.
Yeah.
I know. You're a gentleman.
All right, so that's the news we have. You know what else we have here? And we're kind of, just so you know, it's 39 minutes after the hour.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. We have to do our station identification on Major Nelson Television Network.
There's a brand new studio.
Traffic and weather together.
I don't think
every 10 minutes.
There's no clock in here. So,
I want to show
something. Can you pull those down? I want to bring up something that's interesting that was also announced this week for some folks that may like it. And this is an amazing.
Oh, wow.
This is the new Surface.
He has everything.
Yeah.
This is the new Surface Go. So this device was announced earlier this week.
Yeah, like 36 hours ago.
This, and a lot of folks have seen it, and this is actually the first time that everyone in the room has seen
it.
The first one I saw was about an hour ago. But this is a Surface Book 2, and I just want to put this in front of it.
You have the biggest and the smallest.
Right. Look at the size on that thing. It is so small. Let me line up here so you can see it. It's so small, and it's amazing. So I tweeted out a link earlier to a great video where one of the engineers shows this thing off. Here, let's go ahead and show it, Jeff. And it's really fun. So if you're in the Surface ecosystem or you're looking to get a little something, this is kind of the tablet that thinks it's a laptop that thinks it's a tablet. And I haven't tested it, but I imagine if you have an Xbox One X in your house or an Xbox One, you want to stream to this thing, and when you're in the other room, it'll work just fine.
And I'd imagine there's a number of like Xbox Play Anywhere games that theoretically, how they'll run, obviously your mileage may vary from computer to computer, but it has all of the features of its big brother. So
that's
it has,
you got Lucas's.
Yeah, there's Lucas who works on that. It has the sensor for Windows Hello, which I'm a big fan of.
Yeah.
You sign in with your face. I don't even know what my password is. Occasionally, I get asked for my password, and I'm like,
"See, my Windows Hello. When I get up in the morning, the first thing I do when I sign in, it looks at me and says, "Really? You're gonna go to work like that?"
And then it lets you know. You know, it recognizes me with a flat bill cap.
Oh, there you go.
I bent one. It would think that I was.
It's a security issue.
But it has the pen compatibility, which is cool. I can wake it, but I think it has some.
Wakey, wakey.
But it has the same form factor, the same shape. So, and the thing, it has a special keyboard, which is the same size. But the keyboard has the same sort of
the keyboard comes off. Pull the keyboard off.
Oh, yeah. Well, obviously, yes. This comes out. You don't need it. So this is my favorite thing to do on a plane when they're like, oh, you cannot have a laptop on the plane. And I'm just like, uh-huh. Any more questions?
Yeah.
And then you can just take this and
they're like,
watch
please
Netflix.
Put that away. And you're like,
no, they let me do it. And then it's always a conversation piece. But obviously, you can use it, in vertical or horizontal orientation. Anyway. But it has, pen, everything that the big,
USB-C,
that this giant thing can do.
USB-C on the side for charging.
Yeah, we can look at the ports.
Yeah.
So. And it has the kickstand. And the kickstand goes down, I think, 165 degrees. So you can bring this thing all the way down.
Cool.
We got the better visual. All the way down there. And that's really like a great angle for drawing or for pen or for note taking. And something that a lot of, I would say tablets don't necessarily have is cameras on the inside and on the outside. And I always think about like if I had had this when I was taking notes at school, is you can, because it has this outside camera with a microphone as well, when you're in class and you want to take notes, you can go into something like OneNote and you can just start recording video. And so if your teacher goes too fast, your professor goes too fast, you can just record that entire session while you're taking notes and then go back through and like double. I mean, man.
Anyway,
pen and paper.
Surface Go. It's I think it's on. It's going to be pre-sale pretty soon. Goes on sale. They got an LTE version coming out later this month. So.
I know. Later this year.
Later this year. Yeah. We're kind of getting towards the end of the show here, and I promised we were going to show some stuff that's never before been seen.
What?
So James Monosmith works on the Gear Store. You are going to show some stuff here that no one's seen. Brand new things.
Brand new.
So tell
things.
Us what. Tell us what we got.
Okay. So first of all, what we're going to show off is, so next week, San Diego Comic-Con. I'm sure you guys are aware of it. Very large show. At Comic-Con next week, Xbox will have a presence there, as we always do.
Yep.
But in lieu of our standard fare, this year we're going to have an amazing store at Comic-Con with a whole slew of new merchandise. Because it's Comic-Con, and because we have the store, we decided to introduce some really amazing Comic-Con exclusive items,
so
which I want to debut here.
These are only things that you will be able to purchase on site in San Diego at Comic-Con.
Yes.
Okay.
So that's exactly right. So the first thing is the one I'm the most excited for. So I'm going to go with my big thing first.
All right.
We work with a partnership with Bethesda to release an exclusive Fallout 76 Xbox shirt.
Oh, all right.
This is exclusive to San Diego Comic-Con.
Look at that.
Oh, that
look at that thing.
Nice.
It's got a gold foil Vault 76 logo
so
on
it. So
it's the
reflective?
And it's reflective. So it'll only be available at the show. We also have female cuts as well. So we have a men's version and a female version. Extremely limited, available at our store at Comic-Con.
All right.
Super excited about that. Second thing we have up is to follow up our very successful E3 exclusive Xbox shirt, we have the Comic-Con exclusive Xbox shirt. We have a white on white design with a white white shirt and our black tag. It says SDCC 2K18 underneath that sphere.
That's nice.
That is a very limited shirt for those who want a little bit of memento for being at Comic-Con.
I think it was a men's and the women's shirt.
We have a men's and women's shirt available for that one as well.
Yep.
Super excited about that. The next thing, if you want something a little bit more collectible, a little more tangible, we have the Gears of War mystery box. So this is a special box. I'm not going to tell you what's inside of it.
Because then it wouldn't be a mystery.
A mystery.
Right.
But it's filled with a whole slew of amazing things, all kinds of different collectibles and accessories and things that you'll only be able to get inside this box. That is exclusive to the show. It's all themed around being inside the COG, so it's kind of like your ordnance pack.
Yep.
And so that'll be there at the booth, extremely limited quantities as well.
Good.
Couple other things we have, which are event exclusives for us. They're not true Comic-Con exclusives, meaning we have them at our different events where our pop-up shop will be at, is with Sea of Thieves. So we have the Silver Variant coin, which is, if you guys are familiar with Sea of Thieves, this is the currency inside the game that you hunt for, and we have the silver version that we'll be selling at the show. It was very popular at E3, and so we're bringing it back for Comic-Con.
That's nice.
As well as that, we have the Blackheart, Captain Blackheart Shadow Variant figure. This is the Shadow Variant figure of the one they released in the full color in Loot Crate. This was also at E3 in very limited quantities. We're bringing it back for Comic-Con as well. Only available at the show. So super excited to have those five items as SEC exclusives.
So if you're coming to San Diego Comic-Con, when you come into the... I'll tell them where we are. When you come into the main venue, and unfortunately you do need a ticket for this, you just go all the way to the right, and there's kind of this little kitty corner wall. We're going to be up against the wall. You can't miss it.
Booth 100, I believe.
Booth 100.
Good number. Yeah.
Booth 100.
But because this is Comic-Con, it's a big deal. We're also debuting some items that we'll also be releasing on gear.xbox.com as well.
Do we have pictures of those,
too? We have pictures of those
as well. Oh, yeah, bring them up.
So we do have a new Fallout shirt that is not exclusive to Comic-Con, but it is exclusive to gear.xbox.com.
And now, will this be while supplies last?
While supplies last. We'll be launching it on the 19th on gear.xbox.com, a brand new Fallout 76 Xbox branded shirt.
That's hot. About that. Look at that.
Yeah. Next up we have is our first Halo shirt under the new banner of gear.xbox.com.
Okay, show us that. Here it is.
This one is awesome. I love it. Classic design.
Yeah, everybody knows that.
Halo Needler.
Everybody knows the Needler.
Exactly. This will be available same time, debuting at Comic-Con, available at the store, but also online as well.
So good. Look at it.
And for you, Larry, because we talked about it earlier, a new Xbox dad hat we're going to be releasing.
Thank you.
Yes. That was something. That was very quick pull.
Yes.
Like, you knew he was going to want that. They put that into production at the beginning of the show.
And here we are at the end of the show.
Scripted banter earlier,
yeah.
All leading up to this moment where we have the new black with white logo dad hat, which will be available at the store the same time.
I expect to see you wearing that fishing.
I want to just do a quick shout out to Mikey Barr, who's joined us in the chat. So, hello, Mike. We're busting in the new studio. We'll have you on the next show, Mike, I promise. Do you have any more?
No, that's it.
Come on. It is a lot. I know we went real quick.
Only had 5 weeks in between shows here.
Amazing. by the way, you got Gamescom coming up. You going to have more stuff for Gamescom?
We have more stuff and new
more exclusive stuff for Gamescom?
Yeah, exactly.
Wow. Okay.
I'm going to Kulsh glass.
We may have
just
to have
that
you
in
a,
there
we
right
may
now.
Have to have you as a regular on the show just to roll
talk
out
about
the
exclusives. Works. Yeah.
Now, I know there's some folks that may have missed it or they're trying to go back in the VOD to figure it out. Don't worry about it. Go over to my blog later today. I will have a blog post up that has all of these items and when they're coming and what's going on.
And you'll be at Comic-Con too, right?
Yeah, I'll be at Comic-Con for a couple days. I'll be hanging out with you guys. So you're going to have pins there, right?
We're going to have pins. Oh, that's the other announcement. We are bringing back the Major Nelson pin. It'll be available at Comic-Con and small quantity online. So that'll go live as well. And when that does, we'll let you know.
Second printing.
Second printing.
Wow. I don't even know what to say. This is a lot of fun, so I'm looking forward to seeing what you guys. I mean, it's all you're gonna love. You've been to Comic Con,
yeah.
Comic Con's a lot
of fun. 15th, actually.
Is it?
Yeah.
Wow. So we're gonna have some fun. If you're down at Comic Con, we'll be there next week. Booth 100, all the way to the right. I'll have a blog post up later today on MajorNelson.com with just all the pictures of the stuff we went through and a few of the other things. Right?
Awesome. Yeah. This is exciting. It's cool. And this is just the start. Remember, we're gonna have some really cool stuff coming out too for holiday season next year. It's going to keep ramping up.
Fun. All right. Jeff, got anything else? Because we're going to
No, get me that white on white shirt.
We got to get the white on white. We got to get this t-shirt. We got to get the sweatshirt up. What size is this? This thing seems huge.
That's an XL.
It is an XL.
Yeah.
But they shrink a little. Like your mom always says, it's going to shrink a little. Get a little.
It's what, I mean, larger. It's the size I wear. It fits snugly on me.
Imagine you're going out for like spaghetti marinara, you know, where having to take that off in the restaurant.
Right.
You got to be real careful. Yeah. I would spill coffee on that in a second.
We've got a few more news things to talk about. We talked a little bit earlier about Fast Start and Groups, brand new system update that came out earlier this week. It was probably late last week, so make sure you pick that up. We talked about the PUBG, the test server's now open. They're rebalancing some weapons. What else did I not cover?
I think you covered everything.
I think I could cover
it. It's been a pretty busy middle of July.
It had, you know, for the summer doldrums, nothing's ever dull about this business.
No.
Right? We're always moving.
We're only not even 2 weeks away from No Man's Sky.
Right.
I mean, and just seeing like all the things they've added to that, I cannot wait. We were talking about it right before the show. Cannot wait for that to hit.
Yeah.
Well, you know what I was thinking? We were talking about this yesterday, Jeff, is we are only a month after E3, and it feels like it was an age ago. Right?
Yeah. Before we know it, we'll be talking about planning for the next one.
Yeah. Well, we do. And because I remember when do you remember that meeting we were at when James, when you and your team came in and you guys were talking about your merchandise? That was ages ago.
I felt like it was 4 years ago.
And you guys did, and you were like, you had paper mock-ups and little pictures like, we're going to do this. I'm like, oh, they don't have a lot of time. But you did it.
You did it.
Congratulations. So a lot of fun there. So, all right. Well, we're going to wrap things up here. Thanks everybody for coming by. We're going to be doing, we've got some more giveaways happening in the chat. Of course, we'll have Free Code Friday tomorrow with that controller. Jeff's going to hold it up now.
I don't have it.
There.
There it is.
Right.
Thank you.
There.
Look,
maybe
it's a big set. I'm getting
lost in the coffee.
Could
you move the coffee? There you go.
Thank you.
There you go. So we're going to give that away tomorrow. A lot of stuff going on. We have a brand new, by the way, no episode of this a week on Xbox tomorrow.
Why not?
Because we did IX earlier in the week.
I guess that's true.
So I did that, and that's why we're doing this.
You do a clip show.
You got enough of me. You really don't want to see any more of me. You have enough of me. I'm on your console. I'm in your face. I'm on your...
This is where he wants you to say, more Larry in the chat.
Larry.
Not at all. Enough of me. Anyway, Jeff, I want to thank you for coming on.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
As always. James, really appreciate you coming by.
Thanks for having me.
I want to thank everybody at home for helping.
They're all saying more Larry.
I want to thank
Larry trending. Hashtag more Larry.
I want to thank everybody who's watching us to break in our brand new studio. Crew did a great job. We taking your feedback. They want to tweak some of the camera angles, guys, and some of the lighting. They're working on it. So with your help, we're going to do it real time. We're going to figure it out. We'll be back. Jeff, you and I may be back next month. Maybe we'll have James back, too, before Gamescom.
I think that's a great idea.
Guess what? I think you may be a regular guest.
Awesome. I'll be here.
So, all right. Thanks, guys. All right, guys. We'll let you go. Have a great day. On behalf of Jeff and James, we will see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye.